Hello everyone, thank you very much for joining me. So if you want to see more of me on YouTube and if you want to support my work here, engaging with this video in some way is the best thing you can do for us. So a like, a share, a comment, any of those things will go a real long way, and I appreciate you guys who continue to do that kind of stuff. So I come with some information that's going to help you understand what the expectations for you are going forward and some of the potentials you should expect as we enter into 2022, which I think is going to be an exciting year or a depressing, stressful year, depending on what lens you're viewing reality through. So before we enter that new energy, it's important to make sure that our system is calibrated and up to speed. So, you know, there are things you can do on your end to fulfill that, but your guides are very much on top of things, and I'll explain what I mean by that in a little bit. But something that I want to talk about, something that I'm experiencing personally, is a change in the way that I perceive time. And when you're on the awakening path, that is something that we're all familiar with. We all seem like time changes, either in taking new meaning to us, or our actual perception of the passage of time shifts. So I know that a lot of us, when 2021 began, we began to process time differently. And I thought it was due to the fact that I'm in session with so many people and, you know, existing in that quantum state and jumping in and out so frequently. At the beginning, my perception of time was all over the place, and it kind of settled down as we got into the summer. But now I'm just completely all over the place, not sure if 10 minutes has passed or an hour has passed. So when I'm in session with people, honestly, an hour feels like it's 15 minutes, and it's strange. And, you know, in November and December, I started to notice that change in perception of time outside of session. So I think that's something you may have noticed as well, and my wife has even noticed it. So we have this little joke that it's always 1 o'clock in the morning. It seems like, you know, we put the kid to bed at 9:30, we do the dishes, we clean up the house, and by the time we sit down, you know, it's 1 o'clock in the morning, barely have time to unwind. So it's something that wreaks havoc on our system, but that is only meant to be temporary. So everything in this reality is temporary, and everything in this reality is functioning toward bringing in the next phase of being. So something that you should be aware of is when the perception of time changes, it often makes the person involved feel lost. And the reason that we feel lost is because we're trying to process things, we're trying to process things, we're trying to keep up, but by the time we process something, another situation has entered the equation. And, you know, we're always playing catch up. And by the time we get on top of things, that is completely pulled out from under us. So if you are feeling a shift in the way you're perceiving and processing time, and if that feeling is associated with an increase in feeling lost or stuck, you know, just know that that stuff is temporary, and there are things in motion to correct that. So it's normal for a human being to feel lost in this experience. That's nothing new. That's not something that's unique to the path of the old soul. It is what it is. And it's very common for the soul to get tired of being human. Doesn't matter who you are, that's going to happen. And we find ourselves in the pursuit of some kind of completion, and we are longing for that completion. We're longing for peace. We are longing for a reunion, and we don't quite really know what. We know that at some level, the path that we are on is one that ends in wholeness or a completion of some kind. But the thing is, you don't want that sense of longing for something or looking to complete something to take you out of the now. So when we're faced with our perception of time changing, when we're feeling lost, when we're feeling like we're unsure of what we're meant to do, you can't let the frequency of that moment take you out and put you in the search for what went wrong before or what's really going to happen going forward. You kind of are asked to maintain your presence in the now regardless of the shifting happening around you. Easier said than done. And keep your peace. As unique as our paths are, as different as my experience is from your experience, there are a lot of commonalities and there are a lot of things that we can relate to. And I'm talking to people every day who are describing their experience, and it's like they're telling me my own story. But the you that is looking through the eyes that you're looking through now is as unique and as different as the universe has ever seen. So we are as different as we are the same. And the reason so many souls have been prompted to share their experiences on social media, you know, through YouTube videos and whatever else, is because of those commonalities in experience, so that we can exist in our own little bubble, but still have a team to work with and still have a team that will help us understand our experience. And one common thing that a lot of us are anticipating entering our field is the increase in our empathic abilities. And I know a lot of you are kind of, you know, put off by that because you're already so sensitive and you've been increasingly sensitive since the beginning of 2021. So the energies on the planet at the beginning of this year allowed for an increase in our sensory system that allowed us to process the multidimensional reality or the unseen parts of reality that aren't obvious. So as we enter 2022, we should expect that sensory system to calm down and to find its baseline and to not be so exaggerated and all over the place like it was for a lot of 2021. Emotions were on high. Emotions are going to be on high for the entirety of 2022. But you should understand that the expectations for you are different. And you're expected to put your training and the knowledge that you've acquired to good use. And you are being asked to use that training and to use that knowledge in real world situations. So the training wheels have been taken off. And it will be the ultimate test for you to enter into a situation where the same triggers are still present, but those triggers are no longer able to grab your attention. So in order for this to be the situation, you have to be fully present in your power, aware of who you are and what you're capable of. And this means reading situations and responding appropriately according to your what is now lifetime's worth of training. So what you should know entering 2022, even though we are entering into uncharted territory consciously and energetically, the expectation is that you are to stay calm and centered regardless. And we should all have high expectations. We should all expect a lot from ourselves. And you know, I'm constantly reminded of a quote given by Phil Good. Believe in yourself so much that the universe has no choice but to respond. And we are truly entering a period of belief. And you need to hold on to that belief in order for the systems in place to support you and help you understand the divinity that you carry just by showing up. Anyway, thank you very much, you guys. I will see you next time.